We're frequently asked how to connect up GeoShred to play the SWAM violin and the SWAM saxophone and all the other SWAM instruments as well. This is an application note to explain how to do that.
As of GeoShred release 2.6.0066, GeoShred has native support for SWAM in the form of a MIDI configuration and GeoShred preset number 157 MIDI out control SWAM.
If you're using a Mac, you can connect your iPad directly to the Mac to send USB and audio with a standard USB to Lightning cable. If you're running iOS 11 and Sierra or greater on your Macintosh, you can directly connect your iPad using audio MIDI setup. You'll notice that there's a button here that says enable. If I enable that, now I'm able to send both USB MIDI and USB audio directly to Logic. If you're working with a PC or another DAW, you'll have to look at whatever instructions go along with that type of device to be able to send MIDI to that device. If you have iOS that's earlier than iOS 11 and macOS that's earlier than Sierra, there's a third-party product called MIDIMUX StudioMUX that can do the same thing. In the notes section of this video, you'll find a pointer to an application note on how to use MIDIMUX StudioMUX. On the GeoShred side, you're going to want to go to Menu, MIDI, and choose the SWAM MIDI configuration. And then you're going to want to go under the DIN connector and make sure that you're driving the IDAM MIDI host. You can turn off MIDI in, but we're sending MIDI out to that. That is the direct USB cable connection to your Macintosh or to your other device. Also, under the DIN connector, make sure that you've chosen MIDI out so that you're sending MIDI to the SWAM synthesizer. And over here for preset, you're going to want to choose this preset, number 157, MIDI out control SWAM. I'm in Logic now and I'm going to create a new project. File, new. And I'm going to create a software instrument project. And I'm going to create the SWAM violin going to output 1 and 2. And let's go ahead and look at the inspector for the SWAM violin. Now let's look at what we need to do to configure SWAM to work with GeoShred. These instructions came directly from the SWAM team. The first thing they recommend doing is hitting reset down here. And I'm going to reset to the default keyboard. The second thing they recommend doing is going to Options and changing the maximum pitch bend range to 48. Back to main. And then they also recommend that you take pitch bend up and pitch bend down and set those to a maximum value of 48. So both of those should be set. And finally, they recommend going under Options, MIDI Mapping, and changing expression controller 11 to be the MPE expression control, which is 74. So we're going to choose 74 here. Back to main. And now we should be ready to go. Let's go ahead and give it a try. We're going to hit record and see if we can play it back. Okay, we'll go ahead and stop that, rewind it, and let's play it back. Nice. And here's the saxophone. We have the same setup. We want to set the maximum pitch bend range to be 48. We want to set the pitch bend up and the pitch bend down to be 48. And here under MIDI mapping, we want to set expression to be 74. And let's go ahead and try it. And there you go.
I'm here in the studio with Control, and I'm triggering the sounds of SWAM, which is a great virtual instrument. It's an amazing sax sound. I love playing it. It's super easy. ¶¶